Now it's time for the special item by Auntie Finny. Happy Sabbath, Church.
Happy Sabbath.
God is good
all the time.
All the time.
God is good.
That's His nature. Okay, I pray that you will be blessed. And if you know the song, you're sure welcome to join.
have been to the song. It was very touching. Now let's have a scripture reading. Please open your Bibles. If you don't have a Bible, wave your hand. We'll get a Bible for you. Okay. Please open your Bibles to Joshua 2, verse 1 to 7. Joshua 2, verse 1 to 7. If you're there, say amen.
Amen.
Okay. Seems like everyone's there. So it reads, then Joshua, son of Nun, secretly sent two spies from Shittim. Go look over the land, he said, especially Jericho. So they went and entered the house of a prostitute named Rahab, and stayed there. The king of Jericho was told, look, some of the Israelites have come here tonight to spy out the land. So the king of Jericho sent his message to Rahab, bring out the men who came to you and entered your house, because they have come to spy out the whole land. But the woman who had taken the two men and hidden them, she said, yes, the men came to me, but I did not know where they had come from. At dusk, when it was time to close the city gate, they left. I don't know which way they went. Go after them quickly. You may catch up with them. But she had taken them up to the rooftop and hidden them under stalks of flax she had laid out on the roof. So the men set out in pursuit of the spies on the road that leads to the fords of Jordan. And as soon as the pursuers had gone out, the gate was shut. That is our scripture for today. Before we invite the preacher, may we have the theme song? I'll invite the priest into the theme song.
Please join us as we sing our theme song for this quarter.
I do believe.
She's going to be our preacher for today, and her sermon title is Destruction to Redemption. Sister Moyo is very, very, she's a very beautiful girl, she's very active, she's very intelligent, so don't be surprised when she's preaching. That's everything that I might have to say for now, just to introduce her so that I don't bring out everything now. Please welcome Sister Moyo. And remember, her title is Destruction to Redemption. Amen.
Happy Sabbath, everyone. As Noku has mentioned, my name is Moyo. I am 10 years old, and I'm very grateful for this opportunity to preach, and I hope that you will all be richly blessed today. But first, let's begin with a word of prayer. Our Father in Heaven, we thank you for everyone who's here today. We thank you for the people who may not have been able to come. But I pray for all the people who are listening, and I also pray that I will not speak my own words, but I will speak your words, and this will help all the people that need to hear this the most. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Alright, so first I have a question. Who is a hero? Alright, who is a hero?
Who's a hero?
An example for someone.
Demi, what's a hero? Or Anaya, who's a hero? Can we go on to a slide? Can we go on to the next slide, please? Can we go on to the slide after that? Alright, does anyone recognize any of those people on the screen?
On the left is Martin Luther King.
Do you know what they did to change the world?
Yes, I do. I know what most of them did to change the world, yes.
Bella, do you recognize anyone and what they did to change the world? Sorry? And what did she do? Sorry, also, which one, do you mean the one in the bottom right? Yeah, that is Greta Thunberg, and she started her global activist program from when she was 14 or 15. Does anyone else recognize anyone?
Sir Tom.
That is correct. Does anyone else recognize anyone else? Andrew Lee?
He fought
against apartheid in South Africa, and he became the president once.
Mother Teresa,
bottom left. She went around helping those who helping people. And the top middle, in the top middle is, you might not recognize her because she's an old lander, but Milana, yeah. She was shot, yeah, when she was. She was shot on a bus because some soldiers came and said, Malala, stand up or else we'll shoot everyone. She was protesting against sexism in her country, and now she is a famous activist. Yeah, so these are all heroes you know. But can we move on to the next slide?
Captain Tom.
Oh, yeah, Captain Tom's been.
Sorry.
Do you recognize any of these faces?
No.
I don't know how to explain it. The woman is. She protected her school from a shooting, and unfortunately passed away in the process. She told the shooter that the children were in a different room when they were really hiding in the classroom. Alright,
what was the woman's name?
Yeah, I've forgotten. The young boy is, his name was Tyler Duhan. When he noticed the fire, although he was only 9 years old, he rushed inside to go and save his family. And unfortunately, while he was saving the second person, his grandfather, they passed away due to fire and smoke inhalation. And finally, the man on the bottom was the boy named Tariq. When he saw a man coming to his school in a bomber vest, instead of running away like everyone else, he tried to stop the man, but unfortunately, he still detonated the bomb, killing them both in the process. But he managed to save the life. He managed to save 200,000 other lives of all the students in the school. Can we move on to the next slide? So, do you recognize these? So the parrot was named Willy. When his owner Hannah was babysitting a 2-year-old girl, she gave the baby a Pop Tart and left the room for a bit. Going to do some cooking. But she came back to the sound of Willy repeating, "Mama, baby," because the 2-year-old girl was choking, but fortunately they managed to get the Pop Tart out before anything happened. The dog's name is Ace, and Ace the pit bull. When he noticed the fire, he rushed inside to save his deaf teenage owner and helped pull him out by running around and pulling him by the cloth, and they managed to get out. And Masha the cat was a cat in Russia. She saved an abandoned baby in, I completely forgot how to say it, Obelinsk, Russia. The baby was in temperatures below freezing, and the cat curled up beside her and gave her warmth, and she did that for 12 hours until the baby got medical attention. So you see, all of the other ones, they were also heroes, but maybe a bit less recognized. My sermon will be about the seemingly simple but extraordinary life of Rahab. I interviewed a few people about the first 10 heroic Bible characters that came to mind, and Rahab did not make the top 10. In fact, I don't think I would have mentioned her either if my sermon wasn't about Rahab. This is because she does not readily come to mind as a hero. Not much is known about her background, except that she was a Canaanite woman whose occupation was harlotry, and she lived in Jericho with her family. So, knowing she was a harlot, I doubt it would be one of the best jobs at the time. So, one wouldn't think that she would be capable of making such a life-changing decision for herself or others. I also imagine she did not have much view of a better life or a new goal or an aspiration. But do you know that Rahab was in the genealogy of Jesus? So how you may ask, given everything we know about her, that she was a prostitute? You see, God works in mysterious ways. In 1 Corinthians 27 and 28, it says, "But God has chosen the foolish things of the world to put to shame the wise, and God has chosen the weak things of the world to put to shame the things which are mighty, and the base things of the world and the things which are despised, God has chosen, and the things which are not, to bring to nothing the things which are." It is simply amazing to see how God acts. He chooses the lowest to humble the highest, so everyone may see that love's true source is found only in the Lord. Maybe Rahab wasn't the only harlot in the land, but God directed the spies to her house because he knew that her heart was open to him. In the Bible passage for today, Joshua chapter 2, reading further from verses 10 to 11. Actually, does anyone want to read that? Joshua 2, 10 to 11. Just stand up when you found it and read.
"For we have heard how the Lord dried up the waters of the Red Sea for you when he came out of Egypt, and what he did unto the two kings of the Amorites that were on the other side of Jordan, Sihon and Og, whom he utterly destroyed. And as soon as we heard these things, our hearts did melt, neither did there remain any more courage in any man, because of you. For the Lord your God, he is God in heaven above and in the earth beneath."
Amen. This was a heathen woman's testimony. Someone who did not know the God of the Israelites, but she had only heard about the amazing things that their God had done, yet she believed. Rahab recognized there was something extraordinary about the God of the Israelites that none of her heathen gods could do. Let me ask us a quick question. How is it with us as believers in Christ, who have heard and seen of God's goodness in our life and through the testimonies of others, yet when challenges come, we begin to lose faith and doubt? Little wonder Jesus said to Peter in Matthew 14:31, "O ye of little faith, why did ye doubt?" Yes, Peter walked perfectly on the water, but when he saw the boisterous wind around him, he began to panic and then sink. When we take our eyes off Jesus like Peter, we become afraid. Our doubt and worry and fear begin to grow and grow until they threaten to swallow us. As believers, we must continue to look unto Christ, who is the author and finisher of our faith. When you're feeling worried and losing hope and beginning to have faltering faith, or when you look around at your troubles and situations and begin to doubt God's ability to help you, remember Rahab, who only heard about God's power and she believed. Let's just go back now to the story of Rahab, when we can see that she was a smart and intelligent woman. She was able to identify the spies for who they were. She inferred by the questions they asked that they were spies from Israel. She was also able to come up with a plausible story that they had already left for Israel, when really they were in her roof. This reminds me of my grandfather's story during the Nigerian Civil War, also known as the Biafran War, when from the 6th of July 1967 to the 15th of January 1917, this was when the rest of Nigeria fought with the Igbo tribe, predominantly from the eastern part of Nigeria. My grandfather is from the Igbo tribe, but was living in the western part of Nigeria when the war broke out. Unfortunately, this meant that he was caught up in the war and couldn't get back home to the east. And being an Igbo person living living anywhere in the west or northern part of Nigeria was very dangerous, as both sides were against each other, and if the soldiers were to catch you, you would be in big trouble. Knowing this, my grandfather remained in his apartment, making sure his curtains were drawn and his lights were off at all times, so as not to draw any attention to himself. One day, two men who had heard of an Igbo man living in that house came to search for him. Fortunately, my grandfather had someone living nearby who was able to hide him and tell the men that he had already left for the east, and before the war broke out. And as a result of this, my grandfather is still alive and well to this day.
Amen.
From this story, it is clear to see why we should live in good harmony with one another. Now back to Rahab's story. She was able to give the spies good advice to hide in the hills for 3 days before returning to cross the Jordan. She also succeeded in saving them from the hands of the king of Jericho. This ultimately led to the salvation of her and her family. Rahab was both faithful and a believer. Hebrews 11:31 reads, "By faith," would someone like to read Hebrews 11:31?
By faith the harlot Rahab perished not with them that believed not, when she had received the spies with peace.
Mine also says, "By faith the harlot Rahab did not perish with those who did not believe, when she had received the spies with peace." She showed that she had faith in God by welcoming the spies and by trusting God to spare her and her family when the city was destroyed. Faith helps us to turn around and do what is right, despite our past mistakes or others' disapproval of us. She believed in God and his judgment over her pagan city. She feared God more than her own king, and her heart melted in fear because of the Lord, but by faith it was rebuilt. God also rescued Rahab's heart so that she could then rescue God's people. He did this purely out of love, love for Rahab, and even though she was seemingly forsaken by her own people. Rahab may have carried the stigma of the shame of prostitution. She may have been overlooked, judged, and despised by others, but against all of her community's indifference, God loved Rahab. Sometimes in life we feel lost, but remember that God loves the lost. Jesus came to seek and save the lost and finds pleasure in transforming lives for the better, as he is ready to receive us with open arms. He can and will do great things through and for us. God received Rahab into his covenant because she believed. She found peace for her entire family by welcoming the spies with peace. Sometimes we are like Rahab. We feel hopeless and see no prospect of a better future. We are held back by our mistakes and labelled as worthless people by others. But God calls us to live a completely new story. A story from destruction to redemption. Back to our Bible passage, further on in verses 12 to 15, Rahab made a request to the spies. I will read Joshua 2, verses 12 to 15. It says, Joshua 2, 12 to 15, from the New King James Version, it says, "Now therefore, I beg you, swear to me by the Lord, since I have shown you kindness, that you also will show kindness to my father's house, and give me a true token, and spare my father's, my mother, my brothers, my sister, and all that they have, and deliver our life from death." So the men answered her, "Our life for yours, if none of you tell this business of ours. And it shall be, when the Lord has given us the land, that we will deal kindly and truly with you." Then she let them down by a rope through the window, for her house was on the city wall, and she dwelt on the wall. She begged them to show her and her family mercy, just like she had shown to them. Rahab did not just ask to be saved by herself. She asked for her family to also be saved. This tells us a lot about her, that she was not a selfish person. The spies promised her and her family protection, and this protection was based on the conditions that she would bind scarlet cord to her window and bring all her family and relations into her house on the destruction of Jericho. This was the way Rahab and her household would be saved. I think I see a similarity between that and Passover, when the Israelites had to paint blood on their door. But I just thought of that. There is a comparison between the scarlet cord and Jesus' saving grace. We see a comparison between the scarlet rope that Rahab let down from her window as a sign of safety, and the saving blood of Christ on Calvary. Just as how Rahab and her family were instructed how to escape destruction, so also is the way to salvation for humanity by the blood of Jesus. Though Rahab and Christians are saved by an act of grace through faith, true faith requires action. Rahab had to put the scarlet cord through the window, and us Christians must accept Christ as our Lord and Saviour and act in a way that shows our faith is real. Rahab was obedient to the directions she was given by the spies, which was the only way. The world tells us that there are multiple ways to salvation in God, but the Bible says there is only one way. And in Acts 4:12 it reads, "Salvation is found in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given to men by which we must be saved." Acts 4:12. To conclude, humanity was destined for destruction, but Christ stepped in and paid the ultimate price on the cross, bringing us redemption. Once we come to Christ, we become free from our past mistakes. There's a clean slate for everyone who believes in and accepts Christ as our Lord and Savior, Jesus. Rahab was no longer seen as a prostitute, but one who is worthy by faith to be part of the lineage of Jesus Christ. Just as she was grafted into the line of Christ, we also become children of God and partake of his inheritance to us. In the life of Rahab, we find the inspiring story of all sinners who have been saved by grace. The story is a beautiful reminder that God can take any sinner, no matter how awful they have behaved in the past, and turn them into something special. No matter your background, your past mistakes, whatever your baggage, God can and will transform you like Rahab, therefore leading us from destruction to redemption. Happy Sabbath.
Amen.
Amen, church.
Amen.
Destruction to?
Redemption.
I thank you. Destruction to?
Redemption.
Redemption. Amen. I would like to invite the praise team. Before I do that, I actually told you guys that she was very intelligent. So I really hope you're not surprised. And I really hope you took a lot from that sermon, because I did. I was very touched by it. So thank you, Sister Moyo, for that beautiful sermon. I'd like to invite the praise team to help us sing the closing hymn.